Hello everybody, this is Mr. Shravan. Today we're going to complete the unit of separation technique. The last lesson we have discussed how to separate liquids from sorry solids from liquids, and then we have taken how to separate solids that are not that have differences in solubility and that have differences in magnetism from each other. And then we have spoken about how to separate liquids from a solution. We said through simple distillation, and we said you can place the salty water or the solution over here. When you heat it up by the Bunsen burner, the water is going to change into liquid, and the vapor. The vapor is going to go inside the condenser in the inner tube. Meanwhile, the outer tube is going to have cold water to cool down the vapor, which is going to change from gas to liquid and will be collected over here. And we said that this process is called simple distillation, and this process is the process in which they are using in some companies to use the salty water in as a drinking water. So in today's lesson we're going to talk about fractional distillation. Fractional distillation is a method in which we're going to separate miscible liquids. So we want to separate liquids from each other. Let me first identify what is a miscible liquid. Miscible liquid is or liquids when you have two or more liquids mixed together without separating into layers, without being separated into layers. So miscible liquids as like you, when you add alcohol along with water, both are going to mix together. Immiscible liquids, they are like oil and water. When you put oil and water together, each one is going to take a layer and they are not going to be mixed together. That's immiscible liquids. While miscible liquids is when you have the liquids mixed together in one layer. So in order to separate the liquids which is mixed together in one layer, we tend to do fractional distillation. So fractional distillation is a separation of mixtures of miscible soluble liquids with widely different boiling points. So the main deal that we're going to look for is the boiling point. As we have taken earlier that each liquid has a certain boiling point, and we said the boiling point act as a fingerprint for a liquid, and this is going to give us a clue about the substance that we're using. So in fractional distillation, we are going to heat the liquids at different temperatures as per the boiling points. So when we have a higher boiling point, we're going to heat the liquids at a higher temperature to separate this particular liquid. So we are going to have different degrees in which we're going to heat the liquids in order to separate each liquid from each other's. So this is the fractional distillation. Okay, this is the apparatus. It looks like the simple distillation, but over here we have one difference, which is the fractionating column. Fractionating column is what differentiate between fractional distillation and simple distillation. So in fractional distillation, we have a source of heat. Over here we have acetone and water, mixture of two liquids together, miscible. They are forming one layer, as you can see. They are placed in the rounded flask or distillation flask. Then when we heat it up, we're going to start first with the one that has a lower boiling point. Okay, so we get the boiling point of the acetone, which is 78. It's going to be a little bit lower than the water. So we heat it, we heat the mixture at 78 degrees. And then the at 78 degrees, the acetone is going to move up to evaporate. Evaporates means it's going to change the acetone from liquid into gas. The gas is going to move across the fractionating column, and then it's going to go to the inner tube, which is going to have a cold water circulation to cool it down, to change it from a gas into a liquid, and then it will be collected over here. You might ask me a question, Mister, we said that evaporation takes place between the melting point and boiling point. This means when we heat the mixture at 78 degrees, we're going to have acetone along with water. Am I right? Yes, both of them are going to evaporate, but the rate of changing the acetone to from liquid to gas is going to be much higher than the rate of changing the water from liquid to gas. So you're going to have the majority acetone, and minority you're going to have water vapor. So how to separate the water vapor from the acetone? This is the function of fractionating column. These fractionating column contain glass circles or glass balls. These glass balls are very, very small, and they take the temperature of the heat which is found underneath. So the temperature over here is going to be 78.2. So when we heat the mixture at 78, both of them, the acetone and the water, goes up until they come in contact together with the glass balls. So what happens is the 78 is the same temperature of boiling point for acetone. So acetone is going to move without changing. So it's going to go through these glasses until it goes to the other side as vapor, then will be condensed. While the water, when it comes in contact with the glass balls considered to be a cooler surface for the water vapor. I want you to think about it from this point of view. You know, the boiling point for the water is 100 degrees. And when water is found in a mixture, it's going to be like 102, 100, 300, 4. So 78, when it's compared with 100 degrees, is going to be considered as a cooler surface, okay? Because the temperature is less than the boiling point. So when the water vapor goes and comes in contact with the fractionating column, the fractionating column will act as a cooler surface and will condenses the water vapor back into water, and is going to go back to the fractionating distillation flask. While if you increase the temperature till 100 degrees to separate the water, then the fractionating column is going to be 100 degrees and the water vapor is going to go without changing back into liquid. So this is what makes sure that we have collected a pure liquid in the other side. Let's go through the steps together. When we heat the mixture in the flask at about 78 degrees, the ethanol begins to boil. Some water evaporates too, so a mixture of ethanol and water vapor rises up the column. The vapor condenses on the glass beds in the column over here, these glass beds, making them hot. When the beds reached about 78 degrees, ethanol vapor no longer condenses on them, only the water vapor dies, so the water drips back into the flask. The ethanol vapor goes into the condenser, and it condenses pure liquid ethanol will be collected over here, and the water is going to be kept over here. Eventually the thermometer reading rises above 78 degrees, a sign that all ethanol has gone, so you can stop heating. So this was simply the fractional distillation. You need to know the following. Glass beds provide a large surface area for condensation because it's very tiny. And as you have seen, as the particles get smaller, the surface area increases. And fractions, the different mixture distill over at different temperatures during fractionating column. The uses of fractional distillation. Fractional distillation can be used to separate pure oxygen and pure nitrogen from liquefied air. If you remember the first lessons that we have taken, how to separate the mixture of air, we said we cool the air at minus 200 degrees and then we start to heat the air at different temperatures. So when we heat the air at different temperatures, the air is going to change from liquid into gases at different stages, where we're at each stage we separate a certain ingredient. The second point separates a substance in petroleum or crude oil. That's how we can separate the products of the petrol or the crude oil, the ore of the petrol. We separate it into gasoline, petrol, natural gas, coal, and so on. Separate alcohol to produce alcoholic drinks. This is how also we can use fractional distillation in this particular way. So in fractional distillation, we tend to separate liquids, miscible liquids that are mixed together. You should keep it in mind, miscible liquids. When it comes to immiscible liquids, we tend to use separating funnel. Separating funnel is something like that. In separating funnel, we have a funnel that contains the mixture. As you can see, the mixture is arranged in layer because they are immiscible. It means they are not mixed together. And over here, we have stopcock or a tab where we can open it in order to let the liquid go down. So what we do, we get the separating funnel, and then we pour the liquids. And in the liquids, we're going to have the following. The liquid is going to move down, like water moves down, okay? And then when the water comes at this particular point, then we stop the flow of the water, and then we remove the container, get another container for the kerosene. Then you open it again, kerosene will go down until the kerosene reached to this particular point, and then you stop again, and then you open it one more time to get the other liquid. So separating funnel is used to separate immiscible liquids. Two liquids insoluble to each other will create two layers of overlaying the liquids of each type. To separate, take stopper off and turn the tap on to run the denser liquid, because denser liquid is going to be at the bottom and lighter liquid is going to be on top. Denser liquids at the bottom of the funnel, and leave the less dense liquid in the funnel by turning the tap off and reset the stopper at its original position. So this is how we can separate an insoluble liquids from each other as per the density, and you need to make sure that they are arranged in different layers because they have different density. So in today's lesson, we have reviewed the separation technique of liquids. We have spoken about how to separate miscible liquids. We said we can separate miscible liquids by the help of fractional distillation. We said in fractional distillation, we boil the liquids at different temperatures. And over here, it's favored to use electrical heater, because electrical heater is going to give you the advantage of controlling the temperature than the Bunsen burner. And then we have discussed the uses of fractional distillation. We said it can be used to purify oxygen and to separate pure oxygen and pure nitrogen from liquid air, and can be used to separate the petroleum into its product, and can be used to separate the alcohol to produce alcoholic drink. Not only that, but also we have discussed the immiscible liquids and ways to separate the immiscible liquids by the help of separating funnel. I hope you have enjoyed today's lesson, and see you next time.